So this is the beater. I will call him Snafu. If you don't know what a snafu is, Google it. Folks, let me start by saying that I love survival TV. I would rather watch a bad show about survival than a good show about practically anything else. The real problem I have with survival TV is that a lot of the techniques that you see are either impractical, unsafe, or destructive to your tools and equipment. And watching some of these shows, they take an otherwise good technique and make it destructive. So some of them are cringeworthy, so I just want to highlight some of the things that I see on TV that make me cringe. Alright folks, before I get started, I just want to say that I'm not out here trying to sell myself as some god of survival and bushcraft. That's not what this channel is about. There's plenty of people out there already trying to claim that title, and they can have it for all I care. I do want to say that I've spent the majority of my life, in some form or fashion, out in the backcountry, all over the world, doing these types of tasks for work and for recreation. In that time, I've spent with a lot of really experienced woodsmen, some famous, some you know, some you don't. And I've picked up a lot of tricks and tips and different ways to properly do something. There's a lot of right ways to do a lot of these tasks, but there are also a couple of wrong ways that are dangerous and destructive. And that's kind of what I want to show in these As Seen on TV segments. Batoning is definitely an art form, but you should never baton on a rock or other surface that's going to eventually dull your edge. Likewise, you should not baton into the dirt. Same problem. You should always look for a usable surface. At this point, it should be pretty obvious that batoning should be done on a wooden surface. But there's still things you can do wrong. Never strike your knife with anything harder than the steel, i.e. other steel, rocks. Never let the blade come down in contact with anything harder than the edge or anything that could chip it or dull it. Now, while a wooden baton and a wooden surface may not be quite as efficient, it'll get you by. As long as you consider the wood's going to be burned, the tool has to last you. So one of the last cringeworthy scenes that I see on survival TV is someone completing their cutting chore and firmly planting their knife in the soil. For one thing, it plays hell on the cutting edge, and you could potentially lose the only cutting tool that you have in your possession. The only place that a knife should be stored is back in its sheath. Then you will always know where to find it. So a friend of mine once told me a story. He was an accomplished woodsman of his own, and he was at a survival gathering or a school or some sort of an assembly, and one of the attendees was out doing some cutting chores, placed his knife in the dirt to go get more materials. Well, the bell went out, so people had to assemble, and one of the gentlemen who was running back to the assembly caught that blade right between his toes, which of course ended his trip. And he forfeited his fees. So something to consider. It may not be you that gets hurt. You may just destroy somebody else's experience. All right, folks, for the longest time, I've taken a lot of this stuff for granted that people just know it or understand it. If you do, good on you. If you don't, well, now you do. So hopefully you'll use whatever I showed you to your advantage. And if not, you know, do your own thing. I hope to be bringing you more of these As Seen on TV segments. I'll start taking notes when I watch these shows, and there seems to be absolutely no lack of material to draw from. So I want to thank you for tuning in, and I want to remind you to like, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll leave you with this. If you can't be good, at least be good at it.